Bristol Community College, Mathematics with Dan Avedikian, Math 119, Fundamental Statistics, Section 10.3, Problem 1. This is Section 10.3, Problem Number 1. It says, physical Phil is a personal fitness trainer. Clients of Phil's month-long Lose the Pounds Now program have traditionally lost an average of mu equal to 14.2 pounds. Phil believes that yelling at his clients will motivate them into losing more weight. This month, he had 16 clients that lost an average of X bar equal to 14.4 pounds with a standard deviation of S equal to 1.0. Conduct a hypothesis test at a 0.01 level of significance that Phil's yelling has motivated people to lose more weight. So this is a hypothesis test. There's a six-step process. In this particular type of problem, we don't know the population standard deviation. We have to base our process on the sample standard deviation. So step one is state the null hypothesis. The null hypothesis will contain some condition of equality for mu, and that condition of equality is 14.2 pounds. So the null hypothesis will either have an equal to, a greater than or equal to, or possibly a less than or equal to, but it will have the condition of equality somehow. Step two, state the alternate hypothesis. The symbol is capital H sub 1. You'll have the same mu and the same number, but now an inequality symbol, or possibly a not equal to, that does not contain the condition of equality. So you'll have a greater than, a less than, or a not equal to. So for this one, you want to see that the average amount of weight that Phil's clients lost is more than 14.2 pounds. He thinks yelling a lot will make people lose more weight. So you want to test the claim that the average amount of weight lost is greater than 14.2 pounds. Like maybe people lose 15 or 16 pounds in the month-long process. Step three is determine if this is a right tail, left tail, or two-tail test. So to determine that, what you want to do is look at the inequality symbol in the alternate hypothesis and see which direction it points in. So this problem, we have a greater than symbol in our alternate hypothesis. Greater than points to the right. So this is a right tail test. So the next part of the process, step four, is calculate the value for t. So if we knew the standard deviation of the population, we would calculate a z. But since we have to use the standard deviation of the sample, it's t. Very similar formula. T is x bar minus mu over s, the sample standard deviation over square root of n. And for this particular problem, T is X bar was 14.4 pounds minus mu, which is 14.2 pounds, over S, the standard deviation, which was 1.0, and just call it 1, divided by square root of n. N is the size of the sample. How many items were in the sample? So for this problem, our sample contains 16 clients that are trying to lose some weight. So square root of n becomes square root of 16. Don't forget the square root. It's a common mistake. So let's start some of this computation. T equals, in the numerator, 14.4 minus 14.2 will be positive 0.2. Don't lose track of the sign. Could be negative. In this case, it's not as positive. And you will have 1 over square root of 16 is 4, right? Because 4 times 4 is 16. I can simplify the denominator a little bit further. I'll have t equals, I still have 0.2 on top, and 1/4 I can do without a calculator. I know that's 0.25. If you don't remember that, the 1/4 you can just use your calculator. 1 divided by 4 equals, it'll tell you that it's 0.25. And now you can finish off the computation for t. What we're going to have is the numerator, 0.2, divided by the denominator, 0.25, and you'll see that that is 0.8. So now the question is, does 0.8 push us far enough into the critical region to cause us to reject the null? So here's the next step, step five, determine what that critical value of t is. So this is a right tail test. The t distribution looks very much like the normal curve, or the z distribution, but it's a little bit special. So this is a right tail test. Our level of significance is 0.01. So we want to see if we go out into the rightmost 1%, and what value of t is going to cause that to happen. So you want to go to the t chart, the student's t chart, that's at the end of the homework. And you want to find the 0.01 column, because it tells you is that level of significance. And the row that you're going to look in is 15 degrees of freedom, one less than your sample size. Sample size is 16, so one less is 15. 15 degrees of freedom. It's marked DF for degrees of freedom. And you'll see where they intersect. And it intersects at the value of 2.602. So in order to get out into the critical region to cause you to reject the null, your computation for t has to go out past 2.6 something, and we only had a 0.8. So 0.8 is not even close to going into the critical region. So our conclusion then is fail to reject the null. Most likely, the average is still 14.2. This particular sample of clients, they did go to 14.4. They lost a little bit more weight. Coincidental. It was most likely not due to Phil's yelling. The population average is still most likely 14.2. So your conclusion, step six, state your conclusion. Your conclusion would be fail to reject the null hypothesis. So you could just write H sub 0 if you want, or you could write out null.